What's going on, guys? It's Omniarch, and today I want to bring you a brand new video on something that's a little bit different than things that I've done on this channel before. So today I'm going to be telling you a story, or more or less my experience, when I took Adderall a couple of times in my life.
Oh my god, Omniarch's a fucking druggie. That's so disgusting. Jesus Christ.
No, dude, just wait, okay? It was prescribed legally. A doctor prescribed it to me. Just give me a second, okay? Just come on, give me a second. Now, real quick, before I get into the story, I feel like it's been a really long time since I've talked about my other social media accounts. So if you guys are new to this channel and you haven't followed me on Twitter or Instagram, Snapchat, or on Twitch, which I've been streaming on a lot more lately, make sure you check all the links in the description below and follow me on all of those platforms. Again, sorry for plugging my own shit, but hey, it's been a long time and I feel like I need to just update you guys because there's a ton more of you on this channel than there was a month or two months ago or whatever. So anyway, just so you guys know, all my social media links are always in the description below, as well as my PlayStation 4 username if you want to add me. I get tons of messages about that. Without further ado, let's move on with the video. So yeah, like I said, I'm going to be talking about the few times that I've taken Adderall in my life. Now let me just get this out of the way first. I was prescribed at first 10 milligrams of Adderall extended release by my doctor after I came to him shortly after starting college, and just saying like, hey, you know, college is a lot harder than high school was. You know, I was the kid in high school who was able to do very well on everything without studying, so I didn't have to, you know, sit down and study for 2 hours every night or whatever in order to do well. I could sit down, look over a few things, get bored, play Call of Duty, do my homework, go to bed, whatever, and that was just high school for me. When I got to college, things started to get a little bit more difficult, classes got harder, and I found that I had to do a ton of work every single day in order to get the grades that I needed to stay in school. So I found that I couldn't do it. I couldn't sit down and read a textbook for a certain amount of time. It just was not possible. I would isolate myself. I would go to a quiet room with nobody else. I would try and read my textbook, and I would find myself on my phone or on like the computer. It was super, super, super frustrating, and I literally could not help myself but not do it. Like, I would do it for a certain amount of time, and then I just wasn't able to do it anymore. It just wasn't possible. So I went to my doctor and I was like, hey, you know, I can't study. I don't know what's going on. Like, I literally can't focus. It's impossible. I've tried everything. Caffeine kind of helps, but that's really it. And he asked me a series of questions. I answered all of them truthfully and honestly. And he's like, okay, here is, you know, 10 milligrams. We'll start you off. You know, this is a very, very, very small dose. We'll do this with extended release and we'll see how it goes. Come back in a month and tell me how it is. I came back in a month and I was like, hey, look, this is not enough. And I did tell him that I did end up taking 2 pills every day, so that way it was equivalent of like 20 milligrams, and that did seem to help. And he was like, okay, so let's just give you a prescription for 20 milligrams extended release every day, and that'll be the end of it. Now, this was a few years ago. I don't actually take it anymore. I took it for maybe 2 months or something, and I didn't like how it made me feel. It definitely did its job. It definitely did make me focus. It did improve the way that I was able to study, and it was very effective in what it was supposed to do. But ultimately, you know, I just didn't want to take it. I didn't like how I felt, like my body. I didn't like how I felt after I had taken it. There was just a lot going on with it, and I just wanted to bring you guys a couple of stories. They're not anything crazy, but they are a little bit funny, so I figured I would share with them. I figured I would share those stories with you guys today. So I have two specific stories that I wanted to tell you guys, and then after that I'll tell you why I stopped taking it ultimately, like for very specific reasons. The first story that I can remember, and this was like one of the first times that I started taking 20 milligrams of Adderall, is I was sitting alone in a study room and I was studying for a class, and I remember I had two YouTube videos open, right? And I was hardcore studying. I had two YouTube videos open. I had one YouTube video of just something that I wanted to watch. It was just like a fun video, you know, just like an entertaining video, on one half of the screen. On the second half of the screen was a Fall Out Boy music video, and I was listening to Fall Out Boy, and on my lap was my textbook, right? And I was reading my textbook while watching both YouTube videos at the same time. It was like super speed. It was like I don't know, it was like a hyperdrive mode. It was insane. Like, I was literally paying close attention to both YouTube videos while reading my textbook at the same time and taking notes, and I was doing all of it simultaneously. I was multitasking at like 100%, and it was insane. Like, I know this might not sound like, you know, crazy, but just try to watch and pay attention to a music video and whatever, you know, gaming video that you want to watch, and at the same time retain the information in your textbook. It was just crazy. Like, I thought, after the music video was ended, and I was like, oh my god, that was wild, I actually laughed. I was like, oh my god, I was able to actually watch two videos and read a textbook at the exact same time. I felt like some, I don't know, cyborg robot who was just, like, absorbing all of this information at the same time, and it was just absolutely nuts. And it was insane, dude. The other specific story that I wanted to tell you was the time that I missed class because of it, and this, it was one of the reasons that I did ultimately not want to take this, take Adderall anymore, and it was because I had to study for biology, and I had, like, bio lab was in the morning, right? It was at, like, 8 a.m. or something, and I had taken the Adderall too late in the day. Like, so if you guys don't know what extended release means, it means basically that in the little pill, in the capsule that you take, there's these little tiny beads with the medication inside of them. I am not a pharmacist, I don't know enough about it, but basically it takes your body a long time to break it down in that specific form, as opposed to, I don't know, like a tablet or whatever, where you absorb it all instantaneously. So the extended release is supposed to give you that energy and focus in small bursts across the entire day, so that way it, you know, it's a continuous effect instead of one, like, large surge in focus. So that's awesome, you know, you wake up and you take it and you go throughout your day and function as you're supposed to when taking your medication. The problem is that that particular day I had already woken up late, and if I do remember correctly, I think bio was on like a Monday morning or something, so I had woken up late on Sunday and I knew I had a lot of work to do, so I started to try and do it without taking any medication because I knew it was already late in the day, but I couldn't get through it all. So I was like, you know, whatever, it'll be fine, I'll just take it. And I took it maybe 4 or 5 o'clock at night, I think it was maybe 3 or 4 p.m. and that was a terrible, terrible mistake. So basically I got through all my work, right? And it was about midnight and I knew I had to be to class at 8 a.m., which means I had to wake up probably around 7 just so I can, like, shower really quick and then go. And I laid down at like midnight and I remember, you know, I looked on my phone for a little bit as you do, you know, before bed. And I remember, like, shit, dude, I'm not tired at all. And I laid there and I laid there and I checked my phone. It was 1, it was 2, it was 3:30, and then it was 4:30. And I was, like, just laying there awake. I wasn't looking at my phone the whole time, you know. I was literally laying there trying to go to sleep and I literally could not do it. I actually felt exhausted, but my brain would not shut off. It was like, it was the most frustrating thing ever. Like, you know, if you've ever, you know what it's like to be really, really, really tired. Like, you could just collapse and fall asleep. That's how I felt. And I was laying down for like 4 or 5 hours and my brain just was not shutting off. And I just didn't know what to do. I was like, I'm awake. Like, I'm awake and I don't want to be. I don't want to be awake right now. I feel like I can't be awake right now, and I can't fall asleep. So around 4:30, 5 in the morning, I ended up just sending an email to my professor for biology lab, and I was like, hey, you know, I woke up, I'm really, really, really sick, there's no way that I can be to class in 2 hours, I can't make it, I'm really sorry, I'll be in later if I'm feeling better to pick up the material. And I did end up falling asleep around 5 or 6 in the morning, woke up, I don't remember, at like 1 p.m. or something, and I think the next day I actually went to go get whatever material it was that I missed. But that brings me to my next point and into why I stopped taking it, even though it was prescribed to me to fix an actual medical situation that was going on. Like I said in the beginning of the video, actually went to my doctor and I explained to him my problem, and he did think that I had some mild forms of like ADHD or whatever, and that this would help me, and it did help me. And the reason that I don't take it to this day, it's been years now and I don't take it. I don't even think, you know, if I wanted to take it again, I'd have to probably go to a new doctor, because I live in a different city now and it's been plenty of time has passed. They'd probably be like, oh, why are you coming back asking for this prescription, you haven't taken it in years, whatever. There's a few reasons why. The first reason is very superficial. This has nothing to do with anything besides my own personal preference, right? But I love coffee. I love waking up in the morning and having coffee, especially in the fall and winter time. it's just, I cannot start my day without it. I love, you know, if I wake up and I'm a little bit cold, I love having a cup of coffee. It's just my favorite thing. It tastes amazing. I love the feel and the taste, and like, it wakes me up, and it's just, there's nothing better than starting your cold mornings off with a cup of coffee. If you guys don't know, it's really, really, really unhealthy to take Adderall and also consume high levels of caffeine. It's really bad for your heart. Your heart can, you know, end up racing. You can have very like heart palpitations, and there's other sorts of complications. Again, I'm not a pharmacist or a doctor or anything, but it's very common knowledge, and you can look it up, that it is really bad to have caffeine and take Adderall at the same time. And that was frustrating for me because, you know, I would wake up and I'd be like, do I want to have coffee or do I want to function normally? Like it was one or the other. And also, you know, I've actually have like a mild caffeine addiction, which is something that's really common in America, where if you have caffeine every single day and then you just stop having it, you get like a small headache and it's really uncomfortable. So I would be like, okay, well, I'll take the Adderall, and I would take it, and then I wouldn't have my coffee, and then I get a headache, and it would just be frustrating because I couldn't have the coffee because I already took the medication. So it was just really frustrating, and ultimately I would just have rather just relaxed, had my coffee, chilled out, and not had to worry about like literal a health issue. Like I didn't want to have to worry about that. Another reason that I stopped taking it is because it would make my fingers and my toes really cold. It was weird. And you know, this was around fall time, I believe, closer to like winter. It's probably like November or something like that in New York. So it was cold out in general, but it just felt like the extremities of my body were colder, as if there was like less blood flow there. I don't know if that's like an actual thing or if that was just a personal experience for me. I don't know if other people who take this also experience something along those lines, but for me, every single time I took it, I noticed that my toes and my hands, or at least my fingertips, were just colder, and I didn't like that feeling. I would always like sit there like this and try and warm them up, even though the rest of my body was totally warm, and my toes and everything, they were just cold, and it was annoying, and I hated the feeling. I really hated it a lot, and that just felt weird to me, and I felt like I hated it. Another reason why I didn't want to take it is because of the time management thing. I told you about this. Missing biology, I ended up taking it too late in the day, and I couldn't go to sleep, and that was like the worst experience that I've ever had from taking any sort of medication. So it was just the whole time management thing where it's like, you know, I have to take it before a certain time of day, plus I don't want to feel the way I feel, plus I can't drink any caffeine, which means I can't have tea or coffee or energy drinks or anything like that, you know. So it was just all these different things I had to like remind myself of. And even at that, you know, even keeping all that in check, I still didn't like how I felt, like with my fingers and stuff like that, I felt cold. And the last reason was I was forgetting to eat. And I know this sounds like, you know, a cool thing because you could lose weight or whatever, but I would go like 7+ hours without eating, and I wouldn't even remember to eat. Like I'd go to the library, right? Or like I'd wake up and I'd have like a little bit of breakfast or something, and then I'd go to the library to study, and then like maybe I'd go and get like a snack or something like 3 hours in, and then I'd leave, and the whole time I wouldn't feel hungry at all, and I would leave and I wouldn't want to eat, but I'd be like, damn dude, I haven't eaten in like 8 hours, I'm not hungry. But like, you have to eat to be healthy. Like, you need nutrients in your body. Like, you know, you have to eat a certain amount every day. And I didn't want to eat, and it was annoying because I would feel like eating was like a chore to me. It was like, oh, I have to go, you know, I have to go eat food, even though I don't want to. Like, I'll just eat something, you know, just so I can know that I ate today, even though I don't feel hungry at all. And ultimately, like, at first I was like, oh, that's pretty cool, like, maybe I could lose weight this way, but it's not good, it's not healthy, it's really annoying, and it's not a good thing, it's not healthy, it's, like, just not a healthy way to live. And the other thing, too, is I felt like I was drinking a lot more water, which means I was peeing a lot more. And that was really annoying too, because I just was always feeling like kind of thirsty a little bit, and I just would keep drinking water and peeing, and it was annoying. So ultimately, I decided, fuck it, I don't want to take this anymore. It's not worth feeling shitty, like my body feeling cold and shitty, and it's not worth managing it, you know, having to not drink coffee and having to take it at a certain time and all this other stuff. And I just decided I don't want to do it, I don't want to take it, I don't want to have to deal with this, and it didn't feel good to me, it didn't feel healthy. So anyway, those are my experiences taking Adderall. Those are just a couple little stories that I have. Again, nothing crazy, I didn't, you know, it was prescribed to me legally. I did have a prescription from an actual doctor. It's not like I took it and went to like some crazy EDM concert, or took it and like you know, did these crazy things or went on a road trip or some stupid shit like that. It was just legitimate problems that I actually had while taking it. But I did think it was funny, you know, just ways that I felt and missing class and all this stuff. And I figured I would share it with you guys. Maybe you guys, you know, have never taken it before, or maybe you know people who have taken it and maybe they've offered it to you illegally or legally or whatever. And I just wanted to give you my insight and my personal story and, you know, how it's affected my life in the few months that I did take it. And there are times where, you know, I wish I had it. Like sometimes before a test or something, I'd be like, damn, I really wish, you know, I still have that prescription. I could take it now and just really, really study. But ultimately, that's not the way you're supposed to use a medication that's prescribed to you. And again, like I said, I just didn't like how it made me feel. So now you guys know, if a friend or whoever ever tries to get you to take it, I highly, highly, highly recommend that you decline. Again, it's not legal to take someone else's prescription medication if it's not prescribed for you, so definitely don't do that. And again, like I said, it's not good, it's not fun. You don't get fucked up, you don't, like, there's no like fun, like you don't feel weird, like you just feel really focused. And it's not like, I don't know why people take it recreationally, because I don't feel good on it. I'm not happier, I'm not you know, anything. I'm just like, I even still will feel tired, I just won't be able to go to sleep. So I don't know why people, like, think it's, like, this awesome drug to take at, like, a concert or something, because, like, it's just, it doesn't make me feel, like, hyped up, really. I'm just really focused, and, like, I mean, maybe that's cool for some people who have never experienced it before, but I don't know. It wasn't something that I would never, like, I would never take it, like, recreationally, like, oh, let's go out to the club and take some Adderall. Like, that doesn't make any sense to me. Like, it's not a fun drug. It's like, I can understand why people would like smoke weed or drink alcohol or do Molly or ecstasy. You know, I wouldn't ever do Molly or ecstasy, mind you. Fuck that. That shit's scary. But like, I see why people do it. I understand like the effects that it has on your brain. Makes sense why you would do it. Adderall doesn't make sense to me. I don't know. The effects it has on you do not correlate to more fun to me. It's just like, there's no added benefit there besides just being more focused on the concert or whatever. I don't know. Plus, it's not good to take it with other alcohol and drugs. But anyway, this is just rambling at this point. I just want to make this video telling you my experiences with taking Adderall legally. Again, don't take it if it's not prescribed for you. Hopefully, you enjoyed the video. If you did, dude, please drop a like. I would really, really appreciate it. It's so hard to get likes on YouTube, dude. I don't understand why. Like, just click the like button. I don't, like, please, please, seriously, dude, please click that like button. And if you do, okay, here's the deal.
I might know the man upstairs. Yep, that's right. I might know him. And he said he'll give you $1 million.
Yeah, he'll give you $1 million if you like young man's video today. So make sure you drop a like on the video. Again, like I said, it's free, it's quick, it's easy, and it really, really, really helps me out on my channel. You guys have been showing an amazing amount of support for me over on Twitter and Instagram and here on my videos, and I do really appreciate it, and I do notice it, and I do love you guys. So continue to show me that support. You're amazing. Thank you so much, and I will talk to you guys later. If you're new around here, before I say anything, before I leave, you know what to do. Subscribe. You want to. I know you do. Again, free, easy, helps me out. It'll help you out because I'll entertain you for free, and that's fucking awesome for you because I'm hilarious, and also more stories like this. Dude, it's so late and I'm just rambling. I'll talk to you guys later. Thank you guys for watching. It's been Omniarch. Don't. Jesus. My outfit today is complete trash. I didn't do my hair. So that's why there's the hat. Plus, I'm wearing these fucking glasses. I look like some stupid hipster. Who cares, dude? Whatever. It's midnight. I don't have to look good.